can send others all over the world. A throne nations admire. One day, I shall become the king of this kingdom, and I'm going to rule all over the world.
Who wants the throne?
Magnificent.
Okay! And what are you trying to do? What do you think I'm trying to do, Obiora? You are speaking of yourself as one great and a mighty one. Obiora!
Yes?
This drum belongs to me. It's a lie! It's a lie! It belongs to me.
Obiora, have you forgotten that I am the first son?
Lie!
I am to our king.
Lie, you speak. I am the first son of our father, the next on the throne. Obiora. Don't you know?
Obiora.
Yes.
Obiora.
Yes.
Obiora.
Yes. Have you forgotten that your mother
came to this palace with your pregnancy?
And I am the heir apparent to the throne. Obiora.
Yes.
What is it you are doing?
I don't know. Ever
see you near the throne again. Did you hear me?
Don't beat me. What are
you doing? Obiora, you tell me.
Who are you?
Will you stop? Who are you going to be crying over this throne? Huh? Yes, for what's sake? Because someone must be heir to this throne. And we all know that you are all crazy. But that does not come from fighting.
Obiora. Obiora. It is only ignorance that make the wrath with war with the elephants. Obiora, be wrong. Don't forget that when you step on the tail of the lion, you shall never go strong.
Obiora, you challenge me.
Yes.
Obiora, you challenge me.
Yes.
Obiora, you challenge me.
What can you do about it? Sister, talk sense into me. We shall see.
Thank you. What on earth? Fighting over a throne? Huh? Why won't Allah God to make his own will and choose whoever that the throne fits and stop dragging and hanging and fighting over nothing?
Let me see how that was so that we might see that. Naughty boy. The thing you can just have. After all, my mother beat you. Wisdom is meant for the wise. And I'm going to show him that I am the wisest among all. Let me see how he's going to become the king without the crown.
The crown.
What an abomination! Obiora! I know this is your handwork. I know this is your handwork. Common men like you are responsible for this. And you shall pay them. I will show you that I am the eldest among them.
Huh? You call me a common man. But have you forgotten? But a common man cannot touch the throne. And that is because I am the true king. The first son of our father. And that throne belongs to me. Now let me see how you're going to rule without a throne.
Obina, you think you're wise?
You're meeting more than you can chew.
I dance. Now. Because when it's time for you to dance, dance up to me again. You cannot dance. Because when the drum of Agaba starts to play, you cannot dance the dance of Obina. So, Lord,
but Okrush, that the size for feast amongst the chicken should not forget that a chicken will feast on it.
Don't forget that I am the cat that the back cannot touch the ground.
Obina, you challenge me?
Yes.
Obina, you challenge me?
Yes.
And I will deal with you.
You can't.
I said I will deal with you.
You can't.
I will deal with you.
You can't.
Please, excuse me, excuse me. Is there any relatives around here? Please take it away. I don't like all this. Can you allow this place to be spent?
I said I will deal with you.
You can run.
I will deal with you.
You can. I will deal with you, man.
What is happening here?
Can you clean the environment? What is going on here? Please clean the environment for Christ's sake. Kind of nonsense, please.
I said I will deal with you.
You can.
I will deal with you.
You can.
Director.
Go.
What is it?
Eh?
You're wasting my money. You're with the hired black magic.
Director.
I don't shut up.
Director.
Shut up.
Director. Be careful. How can you call me? You brought me all the way from Abuja down here to this low class artist that I would an artist that cannot.
What happened to my sex?
What is it? What is it? How can you bring an artist that cannot even brush it now?
If you're not changing the cast, I am not acting anymore.
You have to be
okay.
It is given to us. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Can we bless God? Just lift your hands and thank God. Thank you. Thank you. Please, wherever you are, could you please stand on your feet and lift your beautiful hands toward heaven and bless your God who kept your life today. Honor Him today. worship the beauty of His holiness. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you.
The other side when trouble will not turn you again. There is something I want to tell you this morning. There is the world we call the other side. Somebody is moving there after the service. Doesn't matter what your yesterday was like. You are going over to the other side. If you believe it, shout out amen 3 times.
Hallelujah. Put your hands together for the bishop. Glory to God. Take your seat. Thank you. Thank you, bishop. Glory to God. Thank you, bishop, for worshiping with us this morning. Glory to God. This is beautiful. Glory to God. Are you blessed?
Yes.
You do? You are?
Yes.
All right. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Are you ready to exhibit?
Yes.
What are you exhibiting? Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. We are ready to display the virtues of He who called us out of darkness and brought us into His marvelous light. The Bible says we were not a people, but now we are the people of God. We had no mercy, but now we have obtained mercy. Hallelujah.
Glory,
glory to God.
Hallelujah.
This is the only race in the history of mankind that mercy is preserved for.
Yeah.
Are you hearing me?
Yes, sir.
This is the only race without condemnation. Are you hearing me?
Yes, sir.
This is the only race that is licensed to kill.
Yeah.
Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
Without arrest.
Yeah.
And this is the only race that don't fight with weapons of this world. And yes, we are more than conquerors.
Hey.
Right now.
Oh,
the Lord is blessing.
Is He not blessing you? Those of you who are not seeking.
Right now.
Miracles are happening right now.
I can feel
His presence pouring through in my heart. I say all He has done for me. And one thing is certain, The Lord is blessing me right now. Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
The Bible says, behold what manner of love the Father has bestowed upon us, that we should be called the sons of God. He says, so are we. It does not yet appear what we shall look like. But one thing is certain. When he shall appear, we shall be like him. We shall be like him. For we shall see him face to face. Glory to God. Behold what manner of love the Father has bestowed upon us. In other words, you are loved by the Father. Give your chest, say, I'm the beloved of the Father. Say that with confidence. Say that with confidence. Hey, hey. Do you feel God's love?
Yes.
Do you believe he loves you?
Yes.
Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
Behold what manner of love the Father has bestowed upon us, that we should be called the sons of God. He said, so are we. So are we. He said, right now, we are the sons of God. It does not yet appear what we shall be. But one thing is basic. One thing is certain. When he shall appear, we shall all be like him. We shall see him as he is. We shall see him face to face. Glory to God. We shall be like him. Glory to God. How many of you are like God here? How many of you are like God here? Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
Beautiful people. What are we exhibiting today? God has given to us the message of life. This is Zion House, the city of God, the heavenly Jerusalem. What are we exhibiting? You know, it's someone that has something to exhibit that is doing exhibition. Are you hearing what I'm talking about? We have something to show the world. And these are not the things we make up. It is given to us. Glory to God. God spoke to us at the onset of this ministry. He said concerning Zion House. He said, behold. He said, my people shall prosper. That is why we are a people of prosperity. That's why in Zion House, lack has no power. Are you hearing me? Please, I'm just trying to let you know what we are talking about. He said, my servant shall prosper. He shall deal prudently. Kings, you see, in this place, we are very prudent guys. We display prudence in financial affairs. Glory to God. He said, kings shall show their mouth at us. You shall never say kings. Kings shall show their mouth at us. Why? Because of wisdom. Because of the heavenly wisdom. The God kind of wisdom we display. Kings shall show their mouth at us. For what they have not been told, they shall see. Hey, 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 hey. For what they have not been told, they shall do what? Where are they going to see that? Where are they going to see that? Send me Zion. Send me Zion House. For what they have not been told, they shall see. In other words, knowledge is about to come to the world. The kind of knowledge they have never known before. You see, we are illuminators. That's who we are made. Glory to God. For what they have not been told, they shall see. And what they have not heard, they shall consider. That is why from this altar, signs and wonders, incredible miracles flow from here. Glory to God. We didn't make for it. It is given to us. It's an ordination. Are you hearing me? Are you hearing me? Hey, 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 hey. You see, association matters a lot in life. Glory to God. It matters who you work with. It matters who you work with. Let me tell you, working inside your house is working with God.
Hallelujah.
Why do I say this? The name Zion House, let me tell us. Zion House didn't start as a group of young men or women who suddenly decided that they want to plant church. A young man who suddenly woke up and feel that he wanted to plant church. move of the Spirit. The name Cyprus was not chosen. We didn't get it by praying. Are you hearing what I'm talking about? Several years ago, when I never knew I was going to be a president of a ministry, glory to God, you know, we finished from church. We're going home. We're just at the bus stop somewhere at Omoba Center, waiting for a car. You know, we are all there gisting after church. And suddenly in the night, I saw a chariot. People, I saw chariots. Do you hear what I'm talking about?
Yes, sir.
I saw chariots. I can explain to you the chariots that took Elijah from this world to heaven. I saw it. Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
I saw that chariots.
Hey,
and when I saw that chariots, I saw a name engraved on the side of that chariot, Zion House.
Hey.
That was 2001. When did Zion House start? Zion House started 2007. Are you hearing me?
Yes,
2001, I saw that. And I told folks, I said, look at that. I saw something. And my friend there, I said, oh, he said, what did you see? I said, I saw Zion House. He said, oh boy, be careful. That was where we got this slogan. Oh boy, you want to start, have you started your own ministry? Or you want to start your ministry? Glory to God. I said, to fear God. Praise God. I said, lovely. This is what I saw. And that was it. We ended it there. Nothing more. Nothing more. Then in 2006, the Lord began to speak. He said, that thing I showed you that night. He said, this is my vision for the world. Zion House is God's vision for the world. And God told us, there are three threats of this move. Three. Number one, God said, I will give you power. I will give you power so that they will believe in your message. Why? What does power do? Apostle Paul said, brethren, when I came to you, my preaching and my message, we are not with the enticing vocabularies of men's wisdom, but in demonstration of the Spirit and of power, so that your faith will not be built on the wisdom of men, but on the power of God. In this place, we display power. And let me tell you, power was an elementary doctrine God brought us into. Right now, we've left the power level 5 years, 3 years ago. We have entered the might level 2 years ago, 3 years ago. Right now, we are operating on the glory level. Are you hearing what I'm talking about? As I'm talking right now, miracles are taking place in the lives of the people. That is a testimony. Do you hear what I'm talking about? God told us, I will give you power so that they will believe in your message. Because you don't have ordinary message. So they will believe in your message. He has said, I will give you influence so that you command followership. I don't know what you see. As you see me, I am talking to not less than 1 million people in one meeting, in one city. Glory to God. Are you hearing me? Hey, this is the pastor of the largest single congregation on earth. This is not a confession of faith. Are you hearing me? This is not a confession of faith. It's a knowing. Are you hearing what I'm talking about? Is someone over there hearing me? If you hear me, shout anymore. If you like building in Los Angeles, it cannot contain. You like building in Singapore, building in Abuja, building anywhere. The more you build, the more I send it out. Talk to me. He said, I will give you influence. It is called aura. He said, it goes with us. You don't look away from us. We may look at it, but we are not in it. Are you hearing me? We are a special breed. Allow me to talk about this move of the Spirit. We are a spiritual breed. Are you hearing me?
Yes,
we are a spiritual breed. Please come and touch yourself. I'm a spiritual breed.
I'm a spiritual breed.
Hallelujah.
Glory.
Hallelujah.
Glory.
Now the Lord said, lastly, he said, I will give you money. Real money. Because the assignment is large. That is why we tell you that we are taking over the world. Because God told us, I have given you the world and nothing can stop you. Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
People of God, to wrap it up, he gave us a message of life. We call life out of darkness. We don't see death in any situation. But the more darkness a situation is, the better for us. You see, because we are called to display the virtues of our kingdom. We came from a kingdom where failure is not allowed. We came from a kingdom where stagnation, where depression and frustration and death and sickness and diseases are not permitted. They are illegalities. Some mean illegalities. It is not allowed. Are you hearing me? So the Lord said, this is the record that God has given to us, his very own life. This life is in his son. If you have the soul, you have life. This is the testimony that God has given to us. His very own life. Say, the very life of God is in me. Will you get it? Will you get life? Will you get the life? If you see anyone looking for the life, not now you're in the midst, you don't have the life. But we are looking for the life. We have the life in us. It's an incorruptible life. It's a life that cannot be contaminated. Are you hearing me? It's a life that is not subject to bondage. It is not subject to error. It's not subject to sickness. It's a life that cannot be manipulated by anybody. Let me tell you something. Gather all the Jew men in this continent. Put them together, they can't stop Israel. The wicked among us cannot be stopped by all the manipulators on this earth. Is anyone hearing me here? Not because we pray more than others. Not because we have more wisdom than others. Not because we are smarter, but it is given to us. Ordination is ordination. Are you hearing me? Use the oil is God. Is it not God? In God's grace. Are you hearing me?
Yes,
when you are dealing with us, you are dealing with God. That is why God says, Son of us is not a church, it's more than a church. I can't talk any further. Will you please stand on your feet? Hallelujah. 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 That is why through it all. We learn to trust in Jesus. We learn to depend on the spoken word. We learn to depend on the rhema he has given to us. We no longer live by the letters. We live by the revelation of this word. Because we have become the revelation of his righteousness. That's what he's made us, glory to God. Hallelujah. Do it all, do it all. Come on.
Oh.
That is why we are here today. And that is why we are calling everybody to get involved. Get involved personally. Get involved with what we are doing. Get involved with this idea for the world. That is why we go for destination. John said, for that which was in the beginning, which of heart, we see with our eyes and look upon our hands and hands of the word of life. Is it? That the life of the manifest, that life which was in the Father, is not let manifest in us. He said, this is why we ask you, come. Come and have fellowship with us. Come and communicate with us. For our fellowship is in the Father. And we saw Jesus Christ. He said, if you walk in the light, we have called you to walk in the light with us. We are walking in the light of his word. We are walking in the light of life. He said, if anyone follows him, he will never walk in darkness. We shall have the light of life. This is what we are calling him. This one was leading. He said, for this is the message we have from the beginning. That God is light, and in him is no darkness at all. We are calling you to become part of the light. We are the people called to walk in the light of life. This is our life. This is our calling. Everybody has to get involved. Zion House is the move of the Spirit. Everybody who is coming out of the seven of us is persuaded today to get involved. I persuade you. Get involved in this idea for the world. We are taking over the world. This is not a confession of faith. This is a profession of our calling. Understand this so that you will know we are not being. Is doing in this house. Zion House is more. Now, the church, Zion House is the life, God's vision, God's idea for the world. Get involved today. In your little, only two way, in your own big way, be part of what is happening. Because the world cannot recover the grace of this Lord. He's begun with us and he's going to take us to where he's ordained to take us to. That is why, don't forget, we are building on God's Spirit. We are building on love. We are building on faith. We are building on power. Glory to God. This is a people that came up before me, this is my kind. God in the harvest. Thank you, Holy Spirit. As I bless everyone in this room, inside and outside, that peace reign in their lives. I ask that your glory reign over their lives in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Everyone say believe in amen. Please, can I ask you to give me a Jesus? Whether you are standing or sitting, inside or outside, you have not received the light from God. Now this offers you the beautiful opportunity, or you are not sure of your salvation. I can pray for you wherever you are. This one, you are sitting or you're standing inside or outside. I want to pray for you right now. Glory to God. All I want you to do is to raise your right hand to heaven. It's a pastor. Pray for me now, and I will pray with you right here. God bless you. Lift your hand wherever you are. Pastor, I mean, God bless you. God bless you. Keep talking for them as many who are up. God bless you. God bless you. Wherever you are, just raise your right hand up. Don't worry. Let us step over there now. I like to pray for them. There. Okay, come for you. Come sing. Bring up the sing. God bless you. your right hand on your chest, brother. God bless you. Yes. Now, I'd like you to talk to the Father. Ask God that you need Him today. You need a new life in your spirit. Talk to Him right now. I'm going to pray for you.
Jesus went to the cross. I receive Jesus into my heart as my personal Lord and my personal Savior. I receive remission of sin into my soul. I receive eternal life into my spirit. I am born again. I'm a new creation. All things have passed away. Every other thing has become new. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Father, I thank you for the life of this young man. I ask you to engrave their names in the book of life with your golden pen. Father, the devil will not exalt upon them. Let your glory shine in your life. I give you passion to continue in this house. And we're going to do work in them. And I know you perform it in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father, for their salvation. In the name of Jesus Christ. Congratulations. Your life has changed today. The devil no longer has power over your life. You will have a beautiful life today. Now, look at that young, good-looking sister. Just look like me. That sister will be. I'd like you to follow her. Whatever she tells you to do, you do it. God bless you. Come on, shout to the Lord and listen to my attention.
Praise the Lord. Before the exhibition, I want to follow ministries to go and say something about their ministry. And it's right now. I have several ministries here. The first ministry I want to call upon is President's Ministry. Please, we have 10 minutes to say something about your ministry. So we will welcome President's Ministry with a round of applause as they come on the stage. Thank you. Praise the Lord. I want, with a round of vision, I want us to welcome the President's Ministry to the stage. Hallelujah.
With me on the stage this moment is Mrs. Chidima Ubiano, married with kids. She's an enterprising woman. One distinguishing thing about her, she's full of smiles every time. There is no task that you put into her hands. One beautiful thing about her, she's born again full of the Holy Ghost. I want to introduce to you the coordinator, Pace Center Ministry. Please put your hands together, Mr. Chidima. You're welcome to stage. Thank you. Chidima, without wasting more time, I want to go straight. Can you tell us what Pesita is all about?
Pesita, gospel financiers, kingdom financiers. We bankroll the gospel to the ends of the world.
I don't know if you heard that. They bankroll the gospel to the ends of the world.
And we do projects that bring in money into the kingdom.
That's interesting. That's wonderful. She said, we bankroll the gospel to the ends of the world. That is everything about Peseta is money, money, the gospel, winning souls. That's what we do. That's what Peseta is all about. I want you to know that our toll lines are open. You can reach us right now just as we're here, 080-37-333-440 for questions or things you want to be cleared about. Our toll lines are just on. You can call us. We're waiting to receive. Thank you. Sir Chidima, please, can you tell us who and who is supposed to be a member of Peseta?
Yes, it's not everybody that's supposed to be a member of Peseta. You can only be a member of Peseta if you have the passion to give. Praise the Lord. And you know, we train people. It's not all about you having all the money in the world. You can still be a student and also be
a member of Peseta. Are you saying it's not only for Zion House?
Yes, because we still train and grow people how to raise money to the kingdom. So it's not about you having the money, it's for you to have the passion.
Okay, that's the passion.
Yes.
So it's not only for members of Zion House.
No, everybody, like the artist that came with me here, he's a member of Paysetter, but he's not a member of our church.
Oh, that's wonderful. Please, I want you to tell us, what is the program of Paysetter for the year 2016?
Praise the Lord. We have so many programs. We have the one we call Clean Up Port Harcourt, praise the Lord. You know, there's no church that has ever done that in this Port Harcourt before. And Paysetter, we are going to pioneer that event.
Please put your hands together.
We are going to clean up Port Harcourt. We've written a letter we want to give to the Commissioner for Environment. We are going to take up a junction.
Wow,
and we are going to clean up for the government.
That's interesting. I really like that. I mean, when people take up projects in the state to impart life,
yes,
and it's also an avenue to win souls.
Because exactly,
when people look at it, they'll begin to wonder, what kind of persons are these? You know, it's an avenue for people to come into the
community. Yes, and we have another one which we call Paysetter in Praise.
Wow.
It's going to be us. We're going to have so many artists in the house, and it's going to be here at the church auditorium.
Wow, that's wonderful. Especially, can you tell us what are the benefits if I'm in Paysetter, you know? Listen, if we're talking about soul winning and we're talking about financing the gospel, what are the benefits if I join Paysetter?
We have so many benefits. Like, we go out to the world to give people letters. We meet the commissioners, we meet the government officials, we meet the government, we meet the company. So by joining us to meet those people, you can be advantage to meet them, and you can get a job, and you can take your business to the next level.
Okay. You can agree with me that if I keep asking Sister Chidimma questions, she'll keep talking and talking and talking. We won't leave here. Paysetter has a lot to offer. I mean, there are, if you want to get clarifications, we have our forms. We have a stand already. So where you can get more clarifications or questions, there are things you want to know more about Paysetter. You can walk up to our stand. Sister Chidimma is available to meet you, to answer you, and tell you more about Paysetter. Thank you so much, Sister Chidimma, for coming. But before we leave the stage, join me with a loudest ovation to welcome a minister, a guest artist in the house. I tell you, when you hear him sing, you know that indeed this is a minister. His name is Chris Rhino.
The fifth is Zion House Production, Apples Ministry and Partnership House. Praise the Lord. The next one is Church Ministry. As I call on the Church Ministry to come on stage for a presentation, you have 10 minutes. Please, I want a round of applause for them as they come up. Please, you have 10 minutes. Don't exceed your time. Because your time will be cut if you exceed your time. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah! Glory. Hallelujah! Glory. Oh, we are so cold in the house. Can someone give Jesus a big, big clap? Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Amen.
Amen.
Amen!
Amen!
My name is Sister Ifunaya Woke, the head of service, Zion House International, and I'm representing Zion. I'm representing the church ministry. Hallelujah.
Glory.
Hallelujah.
Glory.
If you listen very closely to watch, you know that during pastor's ministration, he talks so much about Zion House. Hallelujah.
Glory.
So I'm just going to go straight to the point and also talk to us about the different departments that we have in Zion House. Hallelujah. Glory. Looking at the concept of church of Zion House, we, you know, one thing that gives a man of God joy is when everyone is on fire winning souls for Christ. Hallelujah.
Glory.
Hallelujah.
Glory.
You know, at every point in time, wherever you find your place in every city, whether as a copper, as a student, or maybe your job transferred you to another state, the only thing that is expected of you immediately you get to that state is to do what? To plant a church. Hallelujah. And watch it grow. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. We are not responding. Hallelujah.
Amen.
To plant a church and watch it to grow. Amen.
Amen.
Because, you know, God has given to us a message of life. An unusual message. A message that you cannot hear outside Zion House. Hallelujah. You know, sometimes when I talk to my friends, I'm like, I don't think there is any other person I'm going to listen to, because that is like that is like contaminating what I already know. Hallelujah. Because I really don't know how to marry the both of them. Hallelujah. So please, Zion House as a church, pastor as our pastor, expects us as the president of Zion House, expect us the coppers, expect us the students in your school to have a fellowship that is running there as a copper to start up a church in your place of assignment. Hallelujah. And if eventually you'll be locating because of your job, you're also expected to what? Start up a church and watch it grow up to this extent. Hallelujah. Amen. I'm gonna go straight to the different departments in Zion House. We have a wonderful service, just like you're here enjoying yourself today. We have wonderful service that is being coordinated by different coordinators, pastors, and heads of departments, and leaders, as it is. Hallelujah. Now, I want to talk to us about our different programs. We gather here every Wednesday by 6 p.m. to have an awesome time in God's presence. It's actually a time to unveil
you know, unveil what God has in store for us. You know, I always say, I want to hear what the Spirit is saying tonight. Hallelujah. So it's a time to come and fellowship with the saints, with the Father, and have communion with Him. That is why at some point we say that being in church is not by persuasion, you know. Being in church is an order, is a must that a believer must be in church, especially in a place like this. Hallelujah. Because there blessings are commanded. Hallelujah. Because there we are being taught love. Because there we are being unveiled. You know, Pastor unveils the mysteries, the vision which God has given to him that is so unusual. It is just mind-blowing. It is different from what you hear outside the world. Hallelujah. Now I want to talk about the different departments in Zion House. Now when you walk into Zion House, the first thing you notice is that the environment is kept clean. Now we have the venue manager. Can someone give Jesus a big, big clap? Please, if you have the head, please can you come up? Hallelujah. I want to see the coordinator, please. Fast. The coordinator, the leader of venue manager. Hallelujah. Venue manager department. They are responsible for keeping the environment. As you can see, everywhere is looking colorful, beautiful. They are responsible for making this place look this way. Hallelujah. And they meet every Saturday by 5 p.m. You need to join them. Please, you need to join them. Please, where is the leader? Hallelujah. We also have here with us the ushers. These are beautiful guys who smiles at you at the door when you're coming into church. Hallelujah. Please, can I have the leader? Praise the Lord. That's the beautiful sister over there. They are people that smiles at you and usher you to your different seats and make you comfortable and run your errands too. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Now we have the camera crew. Those people are in charge of keeping proper record of what is happening in Zion House, of all the miracles. Please, can I have the leader? Where is she? Hallelujah. Oh, come on, you guys are supposed to be running to the altar. Hallelujah. Now, this is Sister Rita Ihoma. She is, hallelujah, she is the leader of camera crew department. Sister Rita, you are welcome. God bless you. Hallelujah. You are welcome. God bless you. Let's make it snappy. Amen. We also have here faith builder. Hallelujah. Please, can I have the leader on the altar? Praise the Lord. And the person of Sister Chidimo Obiano, please. These people, you know, makes you comfortable. Please, and we be fast. And we be fast. Hallelujah. That's a beautiful display, my sister. Hallelujah. Now, they make the place comfortable for you. You're in church for the first time. They take care of you. It is an opportunity for you to ask about Zion House, what is happening. You know, they take your record and they keep reaching out to you, show you love, and give the church information to visit you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hooray! We also have Z Creation. These are peculiar drama group. Hallelujah. People who God has blessed with so great talents, and they keep displaying it. If you are in church and you're blessed with different talent, this department offers you an opportunity. This is the brother. You're welcome there. God bless you. Hallelujah. We have special gifts for you. Hallelujah. We don't have time. We have displayed it here, but we're going to still do it in our stand. Hallelujah. This is Brother Gordon Wallum. He's the head of Z Creation, the great drama group. They just add something. You just watched one here, and they are unique people. We talk about the Z Inspiration. These are men and women who have God has blessed them with great, dangerous steps. Hallelujah. Moves to dance and give God praise. You know, when God blesses you, when God gives you a talent, He expects you to do what? To make use of it. God bless you, brother. You're welcome. Hallelujah. This is Brother Ifine. Amen. 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 We also have the technical. Oh, can I have Brother Bucci? Hallelujah. An awesome brother. Always smiling. Always there at your service to make sure that everything is fixed. All the electric. Oh my God. As you can see, he's well dressed. Hallelujah. He's always there to serve you. You're welcome, brother. You're welcome, Brother Bucci. Hallelujah. Please meet him for anything that has to do with technical in church. Now we have the sound guy. Can I have the sound guy with you? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Now this is Brother Wizzy, the man that makes the music sweet. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. He's in charge of the sound. He makes communication easy. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. We're talking about the welfare department. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Guys who, you know, finance you know, takes needs of the little needs we have in church, make sure that things are put in place financially. Hallelujah. Now we have the protocol department. Can I have Brother Uche on the stage? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. These are people who rob from the anointing every second of the day. Hallelujah. It's a great privilege as we walk with a man of God. We run his errands for him. Hallelujah. You're welcome there, brother. Hallelujah. We run his errands for him. And we make the church comfortable. When you have those people around you, be sure that everything is safe. Amen. Now we have the media. They are the people who publish the church and what the ministries do. Hallelujah. Now we also have Zion Internet Blogger. Please get up on Chinewo Obiana. Hallelujah. They connect and network the world with a message of life. Hallelujah. Online. This is our dear brother. Always passionate, so kind, hallelujah. He's such a wonderful person. Good to have a brother. Welcome, hallelujah. Please, you can meet him for more information. Now we have the comedy extra. These are people that makes you keep smiling. Laughing and laughing and laughing. Amazing. The service, if you leave him here now, you just keep talking. And talking and talking and make the day so beautiful for you. You're welcome, brother. I know you want to talk, but don't worry. We'll talk another day. Hallelujah. Now we have the decoration. Oh my God, as you can see, my sister Ivy, awesome lady, enterprising. Hallelujah. She makes the church beautiful. You are welcome, sis. God bless you. Hallelujah. That is enterprising. As you can see, the church is looking colorful because of her. You need to join her. Now we have the program build. Great Kieran. Hallelujah. He's in charge of our year. He's our sister Chayo. I can see he's running around for the program. Please, sister Chayo is the assistant. He is in charge of, you know, all our programs, all our yearly program. Beautiful sister, full of smiles. Hallelujah. God bless you. Amen. Please, you need to meet her for more information. If you want to know everything about Zion House, how the program runs for the year. Now we have the children department. Please, can I have the sister Nkiru on the altar? Hallelujah. Awesome woman who has taught our children how to respect, filled with the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. You know, she's just mind blowing. Hallelujah. Can you give Jesus a big hand? You're welcome, God. Thank you. Good to have you around. Hallelujah. Please, you can meet her. You can meet her for more information about the children. Now we have the Masha, our great brother, great giver. Hallelujah. Please, can I have what I'm now seeing? A body on the altar. An awesome man. Incredible in all his grace. He's a father. He's a friend. He's, I don't know, I love the rest. You know, he's irresponsible. So, good to have you.
You are enjoying to join the burial department she just taught. Please, as a member of Zion House, you are supposed to be in this department. Praise the Lord. So as she has run out this department, please have it in the back of your in your hearts. Enroll in this department and be blessed in Jesus' name. The third on the list of my list here is Zion Care Department. Praise the Lord. As I call on the head of Zion Care Department to come up to the stage, I want us to give him a round of applause as he comes up. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Thank you, man of God. Let us
When you talk about CC, you talk about cell. And I want to tell you something about cell. What forms a man is a cell. That cell begins to develop to become a whole person. Glory to God. So the life of this ministry depends on a cell system. And CCD is a pastoral executive that takes charge of cell system. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. God has given us a vision. And that vision is, go gather the great harvest and help the people of the world build an ordinary future through unusual signs, wonders, and miracles by the agency of the Spirit. Glory to God. And bringing them into a higher life. Glory to God. And same system has also a vision of gathering the great harvest. Same system is all about developing soul, winning soul, and developing them and sending them to go and win others. Glory to God. So, same system is all about winning souls, developing souls, and sending them to go and win others. Glory to God. Hallelujah. So ZCD, we are here to monitor, to take charge of self system, to feed them, to nurture them in the way they should go. You know, in this time of our generation, there are a lot of ill messages, funny messages, but we dish the word of our man of God to these people and they pass it on to other members. Glory to God. So in self system, we a sinner is being converted. Hallelujah. It's no matter how bad you are, when you come in, you're being converted. And from being converted through self system, you're being developed to be a disciple. Hallelujah. Glory to God. You're being developed to be a disciple. From a disciple, you become a minister. Glory to God. You become a minister. The Bible says that we have received this message by the mercies of God. We have received this ministry by the mercies of God. And for you to be a minister in the house of God, there's nothing greater than that.
Glory to God.
The kind of minister we have here can pass away, but our minister is forever. Our rulership is forever. Hallelujah. So we're here to, you know, nurture selves. Give them the life. Feed them. Nurture them. And how do we feed them? We feed them through tapes. Through our man of God tapes. When they hear this word, the Bible says, as we behold it as in a mirror, we are changed. We are made better. We are being transformed from one glory unto another. Glory to God. The only way to radiate it is to keep on listening to this word until you are made better. Hallelujah. So we feed them through the word of God, through our messages, our texts, our books. Like in Design House, we have self Bible study. Glory to God. We have self manual. Before you become a cell leader, we educate you. We give you a manual, you go through it. Glory to God. When you begin to, you know, pastor a cell, you will pastor it with full of power and might. Hallelujah. Glory. And I want to tell you that Design House, we are expecting to have at least 1 million cells. Glory to God. 1 million cells. Anything is possible unto us who believe. Hallelujah. So we are here to take care of you. And our stand is there. When you come there, we'll entertain you. We'll tell you more about CCD. You need to belong to a cell. You need to be made. Jesus said, go and make disciples of all nations. Who are the disciples? The cell members. When you come, you'll be disciples to be a disciple. Hallelujah. 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 Just make up your mind. Who belong to a cell today? Do you know the reason why God created a cell? It's for a purpose. God does not want only pastor to be a minister. Glory to God. He wants more people that will participate in the work of the ministry. Hallelujah. So when you come into cell, you'll be made. He said, go and make. Glory to God. We are here to produce, you know, stars for Jesus. Hallelujah. Just make up your mind. If you are being downcasted, come over. You know, when we pray in a cell, the Bible says, when two or three are gathered in my name, and pray concerning any particular thing, he said, it shall be done unto them. So in a cell, whatever problem you have, in our hands. Glory to God. So we are taking over the world. Come and belong to a cell. We have several cells and several locations. By the time you come to our stand, we will tell you where our locations are. Glory to God. I love you all, and I'm praying for all the senators, all the members of Iron House, and all the people that come here today to hear God's word, to participate with us. I pray for you that the blessings of the Lord will rest upon you. You will feel good all the days of your life. I love you so much. God bless you.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. And you've heard from the head time care department. You are enjoying to go to their stand. You will hear more when you go to their stand. Please, we enjoy you too. As a full member of Zion House, you have to be a member of a cell. Praise the Lord. Before we call on the next ministry, we want to call on Zion Inspiration. Please to come up stage. Zion Inspiration, please. You are supposed to come up stage now. Zion Inspiration. Praise the Lord. I hope they are prepared. Zion Inspiration, we are waiting.
Amen. My brother, you read the Bible for me.
Why
I preach? You know, God is going to do something in your life. Somebody say, I believe. Say, I believe. No, don't you believe again? Go to the
book.
The book of Matthew 11:12. The other way down.
Okay. And from the days of John the Baptist.
John the Baptist.
Until now, the kingdom of God. Until now, the kingdom of God suffers great violence.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Life One Ministerial College, please. You are supposed to be on stage now. Life One Ministerial College. I hope by now you should be set. As he comes up to the stage, can we please give an applause to our honorable brother? Our brother Kirian is already on stage. Let's give him a round of applause. Thank you.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Okay, they actually asked you to clap for me. You didn't clap for me very well. No problem. Okay, clap for Jesus. Clap for Jesus. I said clap for Jesus now. Okay, that's good. Okay. I'm Great Kieran by name, standing in Life World Ministerial College. This is Ministerial Day. I want to welcome every one of you being here today. Please put those hands together for yourself. Okay, as a matter of fact, Life World Ministerial College is a special school. It's a school, like the name implies, it's a college, it's a school. So we really want to know more about Life World Ministerial College and the school. Because of that, I wouldn't have to be preaching, I would have to take it step by step. So please permit me, let's walk with the slide. Why Life World Ministerial School? There are schools everywhere, and there are school of thoughts, there are institutions, there are college, but the question is, why Life World Ministerial College? Life World Ministerial College, I hope everyone is seeing this way. Everyone is seeing. Please adjust it a little, just a little. Okay. We are okay. I think it's better this way now.
Yes.
Good. Okay, let's go. Life World Ministerial College is a special school. Please take it back. Ministerial College is a special school in Zion House. Okay. Thank you. Thank you very much for this round of applause. Now, Life World Ministerial College is a special school in Zion House where you are tutored on the basis and the fundamentals of the message God has given to us through the ministry of our man of God. Okay? Now, if you want to clap, you can clap. There are schools and there are schools, but there is a school. Now, you can, as much as possible, attend any institution or any school or any college. Yes, good, fine, they will sharpen you. They will make you better. They will put you on a course to attend to the what is it called? The standard of the world. But I want you to understand something. Until you go through Life World Ministerial College, you've not known anything yet, because this is a special school. Now, our talk here said it's a special school that will teach you the basis and the fundamental of our message given to us through our man of God. Is the message of life. If you want to know the basis and the fundamental of this message of life, you need to get involved in Life World Ministerial College. It will equip you, it will prepare you spiritually on the basis of revelation, the revelation of the word of life. Life World Ministerial School is where everyone ought to be. Now, we know presently of the catastrophe that we have in the society. Most importantly, the bastardization of the leadership we have.
you discover that our leaderships in this nation and all over the world are bastardized. It's because they lack the right tool. This is the reason why you must be a part of LifeWorld Ministerial College. Even in the Christendom, in the Christian fold, you discover that the leadership is also bastardized. And you discover that some denominations put up a fight and war against each other. They lack the basics, they lack the revelation, they lack the thing they ought to know about the word and the revelation of God's word. Apart from this, look at the area of God's word. There is so much emphasis on the letters. And what did the Bible talk about the letters? The Bible said the letter does what? Kills. And that's the reason why most persons walking along the road you see, they are not alive. In one way or the other, things are dead in their life. The letter kills. They minister the letters to the people, the Old Testament, thereby making the personality of Jesus as though it is not efficient. They de-emphasize on the personality of Jesus and make the work on the cross very ordinary. The letter kills, but what did the Bible say? It said the Spirit gives life. When you get be a part of LifeWorld Ministerial College, you be a part of life. Because what is communicated to you in LifeWorld Ministerial College is life. LifeWorld Ministerial College communicates a kingdom. It communicates a kingdom. And then in every kingdom, you are part of that kingdom. Until you understand the kingdom, you cannot be influential and you cannot live aright. So you need to get involved. You need to be a part of LifeWorld Ministerial College so that you would understand the basis of this kingdom. LifeWorld Ministerial College. LMC is a place of spiritual excellence. The architectural masterpiece for building spiritual giants in this end time. Remember the reason for our calling. The reason for our calling is to gather the great harvest of souls. And to do what? To bring them into a higher life. You can only get acquainted with these. And you can only be a carrier of this higher life and a distributor of this higher life in full when you become a part of LMC. So until you are a part of LMC, until you go through LMC, I want to tell you, you are underfed. You are underfed. Please, the next row. The basis. What is the aim? What is the aim of don't worry, don't go back, leave it. What is the aim of LMC? The aim is to build men and women for Jesus. Is to build spiritual giants. The aim is to build and equip you and prepare you to be dominary and even in the society. It puts you on the right course and on the right path. Now, I want you to understand something. When you look at the world, you say LifeWorld Ministerial College, the first thing that gets in mind is that it might be a church school. So we shouldn't just go through it. Now listen, let me tell you. In LifeWorld Ministerial College, the courses in LifeWorld Ministerial College, you can't get them anywhere. The courses are such that will prepare you for every field of life. Whether it is in your marital affairs, whether it is in business, in social work, whatever at all it is, LifeWorld Ministerial College puts you ahead. Now, in LifeWorld Ministerial College, these are some of the courses you will see in LifeWorld Ministerial College. Principles of faith and prayers. Until you go through LifeWorld Ministerial College, you don't understand very well the principles of faith and prayers. The different kind of faith, the weak and the strong faith. LifeWorld Ministerial College, on this course, your eyes will be opened. And you would understand the different levels of prayers, the intercessory prayers, all the levels of prayers, until you get through it. Now, you pray and pray amiss, it's because you've not gone through LifeWorld Ministerial College. When you go through LifeWorld Ministerial College, you will be on the course to take over the world. LifeWorld Ministerial College offers also a course called Authority of the Believer. Wow! when we went through this class, we recorded lots of testimonies immediately after the class. Believers' authority. You discover that people went outside and started healing people because they were part of Life Word Ministerial College. New creation reality. You don't understand who you are. You believe you're a Christian. Until you go through Life Word Ministerial College, you won't understand your identity as a believer. The new creation reality. It unfolded our eyes. It opened our eyes to the personality who we are in Christ Jesus. We had a course, the ministry of the Holy Spirit. Oh, it brings you in communion with the Holy Ghost. Bible covenants, developing the human spirit. Wow, this is like one of my best course. Developing the human spirit. Listen, as a mortal, do you know that it is possible to live on this surface of the earth as an immortality? If you want to understand, if you want to know how it works, you need to be a part of Life Word Ministerial College. An immortality is such a person. A mortal man, what affects a mortal man cannot affect that man that has put on immortality. With a man that has put on immortality, death is nothing to talk about. A man that has put on immortality, sickness is nothing to talk about. You come into this realm when you get involved in Life Word Ministerial College. You've been failing in business, it's because you lack Life Word Ministerial College. Your marriage is not working, you need Life Word Ministerial College. You want to advance in your academics, you need Life Word Ministerial College. Everything is laid out. There are entrepreneur classes, there are lot. You want to learn different courses in Model 4, we learned of rapture, and we learned about the saints, the millennial age, and all of that. You don't know this. You all got to know this when you come to Life Word Ministerial College. Life Word Ministerial College is the place to be. Life Word Ministerial College is what you can't afford to miss. Well, as a matter of fact, I want to challenge you today that until you go through Life Word Ministerial College, you've not known anything yet. Until you go through Life Word Ministerial College, you've not understood the basis of our calling. Life Word Ministerial College is the place you need to be. Now, I want to show you something before I leave this place. Now, where we are today, and then where we are going tomorrow. Where we will be tomorrow. Good news. I want every one of you to take advantage of this opportunity today, Ministerial Day. And then walk up to the stand, to this place, everyone to take advantage of this opportunity and become a part of Life Word Ministerial College. Right away, we'll be giving you a form so that you take, because admission is in process right away. So we'll be distributing our screening test, admission screening forms for everyone so that you pick up the forms. The forms are just cheap. It is not expensive, but it's because we want you to be a part of it. Compared to the package of what you will get, the form is only 500 naira. We'll distribute the form. After this moment, everyone walks down to the stand, and then we'll give you more details about Life Word Ministerial College. Now, we want you to be a part of Life Word Ministerial College. We want you to go through it. Immediately after this moment, everyone please walk down to the stand, Life Word Ministerial College, right there. That is the place you ought to be. Until you come to that stand, you have not been in any of the stand. Please, at this point in time, Roland, I want to close by getting you understand something. Sooner, before you know it, Life Word Ministerial College will have its secretariat. Before you know it, you're going to see Life Word Ministerial College secretariat. And in that secretariat, there are a lot of things you'll be having there. You have different halls, you have offices, you have places you would have occasions, halls for occasion. We have our campus very soon. Life Word Ministerial College campus. You see the entrance, you see hostels, you will see staff quarters and all of that. Life Word Ministerial College is the place you ought to be. Now, we also want you to be a partner of what God is doing. Now, note this. When people people are trained and raised in revelation, you discover they become an impact in the world.
Yeah.
Now, when you are a part of Lifeway Ministerial College, perhaps with your cash, you get involved. Perhaps you decide to get involved monthly, weekly, quarterly. Please do so. Because when you get involved, you are adding value to the society. So this is where we are going to in no distant time. Thank you and God bless you.
Praise the Lord. Let's appreciate this man of God for a round of applause, please. Please, I'm joined to visit the Stand of Life Ward Ministerial College after now to know more about this college. Praise the Lord. I would like to call on the inspiration to come up to the stage. Why they are coming up to the stage, our dear sister, Sister Chayoshu, get ready for our special number. Praise the Lord.
production number. I hear now call on Zion House Production for their presentation. Zion House Production, please.
Sounding like we are here for Zion. This is the first ministerial day we are having in Zion House. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So, members of Zion House, a unique man of God, our great discovery, our mentor, our pastor, a dearest friend. He is, I don't know, I lack words to, you know, tell you about this great man God has given to us. And we are privileged to work with him. Hallelujah. And I'm privileged to be the coordinator of Zion House Production. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And with me, please can I have my girls? If you watch what I'm putting on, you will see so many, you see other people wearing the same thing. We're going to be feeding you. Zion House Production is feeding the church this afternoon. Hallelujah. Can you give Jesus a big, big clap? Please can we have the refreshment? We don't have time. We also in Zion House. You know, God has given to us great message. He has given to us an unusual kind of message. I said, hallelujah. Hallelujah. I started by talking about the man of God. Now, I want to introduce something to you. Praise God. Please, can we have the first one? You know what I'm talking about? I want to show you where the vision began. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Please, can we do that fast? Please, church, can you tell us who is on the screen? Hallelujah. This is the man of God. Hallelujah. Can you give Jesus? Expect someone should be screaming. Hallelujah. This is the man of God. Pastor Chinedu Lechukwu. This was him so many years ago. Please, can you? No, please don't waste time. Hallelujah. Now we have another one of him. Hallelujah. This is our man of God. Hallelujah. This was him so many years ago. The vision he had inside of him. Please, can you, don't waste time. Please, keep. This is the man of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Our great discovery. Now, this is him. Hallelujah. From year to year, he keeps growing what? Younger. Was there any changes? There was no changes. Now, God has given us and he has given him an unusual kind of message. Hallelujah. And Zion House Production is, you know, in charge of taking the message to the ends of the world. You get involved. We want to give you reasons why you will make our ministry materials, our CDs, our messages, DVDs. We want to tell you why the reason why you will make it your number one companion, your number one friend, your associate. Hallelujah. Now listen, the Bible says that the word that faith cometh by what? Hearing. And hearing what? The word of God. I have a lot to share for you, but I'm going to be brief. Now, if what do you share when you don't listen to the message? Can you imagine your morning? You wake up in the morning, early morning, and you slot in, you know, a message that say, I have an indestructible life. Can you imagine what your day will be? Now, can you imagine someone who you have looked in your account everywhere and there is no cash? And you're like, the devil is telling you, man, you're broke. And the vision is telling us that we don't get broke here. And you slot in the CD that says cash now. Hallelujah. And can you imagine what is going to happen in your account? Praise the Lord. And we want you to please pass these messages to the ends of the world. Now we have a beautiful project. Hallelujah. We're unveiling our South African project 2017. Hallelujah. A man of God is hitting South Africa 2017 February. Hallelujah. Now, how are you going to be part of this message being spread all over the world? So many lives are perishing out there. So many people don't know their left and right, yet they are believers. But God has given us a different kind of message, a special kind of message. They need to hear this message. South Africa needs to hear this message. Hallelujah. And we are conquering that city. We have made just a little project for you to be part of what God is going to do in South Africa as the man of God. He's South Africa in February 2017. Now, this is an envelope and you're going to partner with it. You say, as a new monthly partner, you know, you register with the ladies, you see, with beautiful colors of dress, you know, you register with them And then if you have your cash, you give them. If you don't have now, then you tell us when you're going to give it. Is it that monthly, weekly, or quarterly? Or it depends on how you want to run it, but we want you to be faithful. Hallelujah. Because South African project is what? Is a reality. Hallelujah. And we need someone who's going to say, Zion House Production, we are supporting this trip with nothing less than 10,000 CDs. Hallelujah. We need someone who say, okay, we are supporting this trip with nothing less than 1,500 CDs, 200 CDs, 100 CDs. Because the message must be preached. Whether you like it or not, the message must be preached. The message God has given to a man of God, the vision he has. You know, he said he's pregnant. And indeed, he's pregnant. He's pregnant with a vision. And the world is hungry. They want to hear this. They want to hear this. Zion House, please, make our CDs make it a daily routine. When you wake up in the morning, play the CDs. When you are going out for work, play it inside your car. When you're back home, play it before you go to bed. And I tell you, your life will never remain the same. I want you to try this. Give it to your friends. That is the best gift you can give to them. Please, I want to urge everyone coming under the sound of my voice, do not leave this house until you visit Zion House Production Stand. Because there, we have so many virtues, beautiful CDs to give to you that you need to give to your friends. I tell you this message, someone who was dead, you know, someone who was sick in the hospital, has been given this message and the person received healing. The person doesn't need pastor to lay hand on him or her. Someone who is broke has listened to this message and today he's a busted millionaire. I'm telling you testimonies. I have a friend that I gave journey to wealth. You know, he was so downcast, he never had money. You know, he was just struggling. And after listening to journey to wealth, he gave it to five of his friends. I tell you something, including him and that, those five of his friends are billionaires today just because they obeyed a simple instruction and did what? Listen to Journey to Wealth. We have cash now, we have prosperity convention, we have beautiful CDs, healing from heaven. We have so many CDs to give to you. Please visit our stand. We also have light refreshment for you. And God is going to embarrass you with great riches. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, our dear sister, the coordinator of Zion House Production. We are waiting Campus Ministries now. Campus Ministries. As Campus Ministries are coming up, our one partnership arms together ready. Praise the Lord. Campus Ministries, it's your turn.
Welcome you to the first ever Mysterial Day in Zion House. I thought you should be clapping. It's my pleasure to talk about the campus ministry. Our man of God, Pastor Shinedu Mileshiku, has a special ministry for the campus students, given to him by God, not just in this country, but in the entire continent and the world at large. As it were, we are already on with the campus ministry, with a network of fellowships in over 20 campuses in this country. The campus ministry is called Zion Life Word and we'll be holding our first campus national convention in the University of Calabar from 20 to 23rd of October 2016. God has given us the message of life and the students are playing a central role in networking this message all over the world. Ladies and gentlemen, the Bible says, the Lord gave the word, great was the company of those that published it. Psalm 68, verse 11. Our mission, therefore, is to persuade you to become part of this establishment of campuses, campus fellowships in all institutes of higher learning, learn and the globe through your finances. It's our firm belief that God will bless you when you become part of this partnership financially. May I then finally, with a singular privilege, invite you over to the campus ministry stand so you can feel the stuff we're made of. Once again, while we wait for you in our stand, welcome and God bless. And I'm Sister Destiny Mami. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Sister Destiny. Please, we are all enjoying to visit them at their stand, campus ministry stand. I think they are somewhere located in the church. You can see they are there, they are waving at you. So after now, you can look at them. Praise the Lord. At the church, I invite the partnership arm to come to the stage for their presentation. Thank you. A round of applause for our mommy. As she steps onto the stage, I will please give her a round. Please, let's clap for her, please. Let's clap for her. Thank you. You're welcome.
The world's richest church. The world's most sophisticated people. The people that has the world wisdom. Zion House. I'm starting to talk on partnership in Zion House. Partnership is one of the ministries, but there are various partnerships which I want to mention. You can write them down as I mention them one after the other. We have the mission partnership. We have production, we have Help the World, we have Bible Connection, we have the Children Partnership, Zion Television, Stage Set, Builders, and Healing School, for now. I said for now, many more are coming up. I'm going to start with Mission Partnership. Mission Partnership, they are the people that take up the Zion House vision. And what does the Zion House vision say? Say, gather the great harvest and help the people of the world build an unbeatable future. And how do they help in gathering this great harvest? They are missionaries. They are meant to go out to establish and finance churches all over the world. The Bible says in Matthew 28:19-20. Say, go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them, I'm going to be with you till the end of the age. These are the duty of the missionaries. They go out and reach the people, even in the local areas, planting churches, building churches, just as the Bible says. Praise the Lord. Zion House will soon be going to South Africa next year, 2017. And it is the duty of the missionaries to go there and water the place and keep the place in place for us to be there. Praise the Lord. So Zion House is just like an arm carrying the vision of Zion House, because it says gather the great harvest. Praise the Lord. Now, some of you may be saying, what is partnership? Partnership is just a cooperative relationship between a people or group and agree to share a responsibility in order to achieve a specific goal. And what is that specific goal? The specific goal is making sure that the work of the master does not suffer loss, and also promoting the gospel of Jesus Christ. Praise the Lord. Now we talk about production partnership. Production means the act of making or creating or producing something. They make sure that the message that God has given to the man of God, a message of life, goes out of the circle, goes into places they serve.
What was using it before?
What are the benefits? You will become a carrier of light, because the word of God is light. Therefore, if you decorate the altar of God, you will exhibit life. And also, it's a place of exchange. What is it that you need to exchange in your life? Come to the altar of God, decorate this altar, and everything will be put into place, and you will never be able to say, praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. We talk about Jesus partnership. This group of people have the ambition towards building the house of God. You know what you need to be a protector in the building of the house of God? Every Sunday, every Wednesday, we say, builders, and we put our seed and all that. And you know the vision and our partner, that we are building the best and the biggest auditorium. Praise the Lord in this nation. Will you be a partner? These people are the forefront of making sure that man in Zion shall say they are sick. This partnership is raised up for Zion House, because we don't get sick. They are raised for the world. They stand in the gap to pray for the sick. And we do have healing. Healing from heaven every day. And this is where people come in and receive their healing. Praise the Lord. Can you join this healing partnership and stand in the gap? They go to hospitals, they go to places to pray for people, give them hands, and when anybody is sick, comes into this place, they get sick. We don't get sick in Zion, but they are raised to help the world. Praise the Lord. They are helped. They are helpers to the world, to pray for them, to go to this place, to go to this place, to help. Therefore, I enjoy to join these partners and become one of them. Partner in Zion House. We have so many of them. I want to tell you how you can partner. You are not going to write exam in partnering with any of them. You are not paying any money. You can partner weekly. You can partner daily. You can partner monthly. However, there is no.
Okay, is to make sure that the message of not having a family is taking place over the face of the world. prayed, and the Holy Ghost revealed this to us. The man of God is eating salvation in 2017. And if you want this thing, you can get to every Sunday. Anyone who is on the street, in their houses, they must hear this message. I'm sorry. Now, how do people work now? This is an enclosed heaven. You indicate what comes from points. Why? Totally, you can say it. You can decide to make a sense. Someone already comes from 5,000, 10,000, 5,000, 1,000,000.
Money to do something, and the person who uses it to buy it, you'll be very
about it. There has been a time that you are able, and one of the things happened and you began here. Wow, now, ministry takes meaning in the world. What we do is we minister to people that are sick, people that have some ailments, we bring them to church, and the man of God in his daily session, they lay hands on this person and they regain their self. They are healed totally because one, the man of God, anointing has been transferred on the man of God to them. And every infirmity in their life has been taken care of. Now you see that they become used, those that cannot run, those that cannot walk, you see that they start forming with strength. They can run from the ends of the world to the other, all because of healing. So now, in order to take this healing to the ends of the world, this healing now has to be, the packaging arm has to be created based on healing. Who's with that healing school? Now, you being a member of healing school, partner with us, your money goes a long way in taking healing. There are persons in Brazil, in Angola that don't know you, but because of we are able to partner with many schools, your money now represents you. Now, your money to the man of God goes a long way. The man of God visits those places and he ministers to him and they get healed. How is that possible? Because the man of God went there through your partner. So what we do is we are going to people to come to village to start partner with us to see that. Now, good, it's a good people. They can partner daily, monthly, as the case may be. Now we have our man of our school. We probably have our public close inside of it. Whereby they feel and then all the amount they are partnering. Every month now they submit it to the boss or the company that the center of the inside.
Thank you. Thank you. calming down. There is something you really need to understand. When you go to veterinary school, they give you BSC certificates and so on. But in Life of Ministerial College, when you come to Life of Ministerial College, we give you life certificates. And this life certificate puts you on a position and far above your contemporary. You know, when you have knowledge or BSC certificate without revelation, you are like a man that has added big stress to yourself. Yes, that's true. But when you get to Life World Ministerial College, we communicate the revelation of the New Testament, of the new creation reality. That's why everyone is advised to come and be a student of Life World Ministerial College. The vision is two men for Jesus that will take over the world and spread the ministry that God has given our man of God, Pastor Chinedu Kelechi, the message of life. That's the vision, that's the aim, that's the focus. Two men that will take over this world and be influential in every ramification of life. Yeah, the school is affecting life already. Not can, it's affecting life. If, for example, you check out the products of the school already, 70 or 80% of whatever happened here are products pioneered by the products of the students of this school. So you see, lives are being affected. Now you discover that when the school, anyone that goes through the school, goes through this revelation life experience, the person becomes a value and an effect in the society. You understand? And the devil. Now, the major problem of the society is the devil. When people go through this school, they put them on that pedestal, that platform, where they put the devil out of their life, out of the life of people like that. So being a part of this school affects the society. Yeah. You know, it's a great opportunity for people to be part of what God is doing, part of LMC, okay? Now, when you partner with LMC, you are adding value to the society. Because as much as people graduate from LMC and affecting life in society, you're also affecting life. So we encourage people to partner with LMC. Now, you can partner with LMC monthly or quarterly. You can decide to bring in giving to LMC, maybe 1,000, 2,000, 5,000, 1 million. Decide to say it in any quarter you want to appreciate to whatever you want to call. Because there is a future. We have a secretariat that will build. We have a campus and mind blowing. Everyone is going to be in LMC.
living and everything we do for God is things of the Lord. Oh, it is something it is something that the whole world, when they watch it, they will say it is plain to the eyes of God. Something great happened there. It was so amazing and so backward.
Thank you, sir.
Wow. To help the people of the world,